Hello friends, welcome back in Rose Project. This project is conducted by Rohit Shikshan Samstha, Sadhguru Gadgil Maharaj College, Karad. Myself, Jagtap SR. Currently, we are discussing a chapter, Mechanical Properties of Fluids. Now in this lecture, we will discuss about equation of continuity. Bernoulli's equation, and last point is applications of Bernoulli's equation. First point is equation of continuity. For steady flow, the velocity of the particle remains constant at a given point, but it can vary from point to point. The fluid is incompressible. The particles move faster through a narrow section and slow down while moving through a wider section. If the fluid does not move faster in a narrow region, it will be compressed to fit into the narrow space. Consider A1 and A2 be the area of cross section located at point A and at point B. Okay, here is area of cross section A1 and here is area of cross section A2. The mass is neither created nor destroyed within the tube. That is, mass M of the fluid enters in a section A1. That is, the mass enters in a section A1. Is equal to the mass of the fluid which leave the section A2. Mass entering section A1 is equal to mass leave the section A2. Okay, therefore we can write here mass of the fluid in section EFGH. Mass of the fluid in section EFGH is equal to mass of the fluid in a section PQRS. As we know that density is equal to mass per unit volume. Converting this formula into the mass, we can write here mass is equal to density multiplied by volume. Also, we know that the volume is equal to area of cross section multiplied by length. But basically, we know that velocity is equal to distance divided by time. Actually, formula of the velocity is equal to displacement divided by time, but in this case we use distance. And considering distance is equal to the length, so we can write here velocity is equal to length divided by time. Therefore, converting this formula into the length, we can write here length is equal to velocity multiplied by time. Equation 4, in equation 3, we can write here volume is equal to, we know that volume is equal to area multiplied by length, but length is equal to velocity multiplied by time. Therefore, consider this is equation number 5. Equation number 5, put in equation 2, we can write here mass is equal to density multiplied by volume, that is converting volume into the area, velocity and time. Finally, we can write here mass is equal to density into area multiplied by velocity multiplied by time. By using equation number 6, in equation number 1, we can write here mass of the fluid in section EFGH is equal to mass of the fluid in section PQRS. So, we can write here rho for density. For section EFGH, we can write here area of cross section A1. Velocity at that point is V1 and time is delta t. Similarly, we can write here rho A2 V2 delta t. Cancelling rho, that is density on the both side, and time delta t on the both side, we can write here A1V1 is equal to A2V2. It implies that area into velocity is equal to constant. As we know that area into velocity is equal to constant, but converting formula of the velocity in distance divided by time, we can write here AV is equal to area multiplied by distance divided by time. But we know that considering the distance as a length, so area multiplied by length is volume. We can write here area into velocity is equal to volume divided by time. Also, we can write here AV is equal to delta V divided by dt. The quantity dV divided by dt is the volume of the fluid per unit time passing through any cross section. It is called as a volume flux. The equation, the continuity equation, says that volume rate of flow of an incompressible fluid for a steady flow is the same throughout the flow. Also, equation 8 is called as a equation of continuity. Now the next point is Bernoulli equation. Bernoulli observed that the speed of a fluid in a narrow region increases, but internal pressure of the fluid in the same narrow region decreases. That is, according to the Bernoulli, when the speed increases, pressure decreases. This phenomenon is called Bernoulli's principle. Bernoulli's equation relates the speed of the fluid at a point. It is an application of work energy theorem for a fluid in a flow. Let V1, A1, P1 and V2, A2, P2 be the speed of the fluid, area of cross section and pressure at the lower end P and upper end R respectively. Consider this is the P lower end and this is the R upper end. Okay. At the lower end, V1 be the velocity, A1 be the area of cross section and P1 be the force. At the upper end, V2 be the velocity, A2 be the area of cross section and P2 be the pressure. D1 and D2 be the distance traveled by the fluid at P and at R during the time interval dt with velocity V1 and V2 respectively. As we know that pressure is equal to force divided by area, therefore force is equal to pressure into area. Therefore, P1, A1 and P2, A2 be the forces acting on the equation of the continuity. The volume of dV of a fluid passing through the any cross section during the time interval delta t is the same. Okay, so we can write here dV is equal to A1 D1 is equal to A2 D2. dV means volume of flow. There is no internal friction in a fluid as fluid is ideal. Therefore, the net work done on the element by the surrounding fluid during the flow from P to R is work done W is equal to P1 A1 D1. That is, as we know that work done is equal to pressure into volume. So volume A1 D1 minus P2 A2 D2. A1 D1 is dV, A2 D2 is dV. Therefore, taking the dV as a common, we can write here W is equal to P1 minus P2 into dV. We know that the work done is equal to change in kinetic energy and gravitational potential energy. So we can write here W is equal to delta KE, KE kinetic energy plus delta PE, PE means potential energy. At the beginning of the time interval dt, the mass, as you know that mass is equal to density into volume, density rho, and volume is A1 D1 and rho A2 D2 between the section PQ, that is, this is the section PQ, okay, and RS respectively, this is the section RS. Therefore, kinetic energy at PQ section is, we know that kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 mass into velocity square. Mass here is 1 by 2 mass rho A1 D1 and V1 with the velocity at the section PQ, therefore V1 square. And kinetic energy at the section RS is 1 by 2 rho A2 D2 V2 square. Therefore, change in kinetic energy is delta KE is equal to 1 by 2 rho A2 D2 V2 square minus 1 by 2 rho A1 D1 V1 square. Therefore, we know that A2 D2 and A1 D1 is equal to dV. Therefore, we can write here kinetic, that is change in kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 rho dV into V2 square minus 1 by 2 rho dV into V1 square. Taking rho dV and 1 by 2 as a common, we can write here kinetic energy is equal to, that is a change in kinetic energy is equal to 1 by 2 rho dV in bracket V2 square minus V1 square. Also, at the beginning of the time interval delta, sorry, dt, the gravitational potential energy between the P and Q is, we know that gravitational potential energy is mgh. So, mgh1 is equal to rho A1 D1 gh1. As we know that A1 D1 is volume, that is dV, so we can write here mgh1 is equal to rho dV g into h1. Similarly, we can write here for the section RS, we can write here mgh2 is equal to rho dV g h2. Therefore, the net change in gravitational potential energy during the time interval dt is change in potential energy delta PE is equal to rho dV g h2 minus rho dV g h1. Taking the rho dV g as a common, we can write here change in potential energy is equal to rho dV g in bracket h2 minus h1. Substituting equation number 2, 4 and equation number 5 in equation number 3, we can write here W is equal, that is work done is equal to change in kinetic energy plus change in potential energy. Therefore, work done P1 minus P2 bracket complete into dV is equal to 1 by 2 rho dV in bracket V2 square minus V1 square plus rho dV g h2 minus h1. This is the change in kinetic energy and this is the change in potential energy. Okay. So, cancelling the dV on the both sides, we can write here P1 minus P2 is equal to 1 by 2 rho V2 square minus V1 square plus rho g in bracket h2 minus h1. The equation number 6 is Bernoulli's equation. The work done per unit volume of a fluid by the surrounding fluid is equal to sum of change in kinetic energy and potential energies per unit volume that occurs during the flow. The equation number 6 can also be written as P1 minus P2 is equal to 1 by 2 rho V2 square minus V1 square plus rho G H2 minus H1. Therefore, multiplying inside the bracket here by 1 by 2 rho and here rho into G. We can write here P1 minus P2 is equal to 1 by 2 rho V2 square minus 1 by 2 rho V1 square plus rho G H2 minus rho G H1. And shifting some terms, finally we can write here P1 plus 1 by 2 rho V1 square plus rho G H1 is equal to P2 plus 1 by 2 rho V2 square plus rho G H2. Therefore, in general, we can write here P plus 1 by 2 rho V square plus rho G H is equal to constant. This is also Bernoulli's equation. Now, there are some applications of the Bernoulli's equation. The first application is speed of efflux. The word efflux means fluid outflow. Torricelli discovered that the speed of the efflux from an open tank is given by a formula identical to that of the freely falling body. Consider a fluid of density rho filling in a tank of larger cross-sectional area having a orifice of cross-sectional area A2 at the bottom, such that A1 is very very greater than A2. The liquid flows out of the tank through the orifice. This is the tank and this is the orifice. Here is area of cross section A1 and orifice has area of cross section A2, such that A1 is very very greater than A2. Let V1 and V2 be the speed of the liquid at A1 and A2 respectively. Here is speed is V1 and at the orifice speed is V2. As both inlet and outlet are exposed to atmosphere, the pressure at this position equal to the atmospheric pressure. If the height of the free surface above the orifice is h, using the Bernoulli's equation, we can write here PO plus 1 by 2 rho V1 square plus rho G H is equal to PO plus 1 by 2 rho V2 square. Using equation of continuity, we can write here A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Therefore, V1 is equal to A2 divided by A1 into V2. Putting this in equation number first, we can write here P0 plus 1 by 2 rho A2 divided by A1 bracket square into V2 square plus rho G H is equal to P0 plus 1 by 2 rho V2 square. Cancelling the P0 on the both sides, we can write here 1 by 2 rho A2 divided by A1 bracket square into V2 square plus rho G H is equal to 1 by 2 rho V2 square. subtract, cancelling the rho on the both hand side and multiplying both hand side by 2. We can write here 2 and 1 by 2 gets cancelled. That is a 2 divided by a 1 bracket square into v 2 square plus multiplying by 2. Here we can write here 2 g h is equal to v 2 square. Shifting the first term of the left hand side toward the right, we can write here 2 g h is equal to v 2 square minus a 2 divided by a 1 bracket square into v 2 square. Taking the v2 square as a common, we can write here in bracket 1 minus a2 divided by a1 bracket square, bracket square bracket complete, into v2 square is equal to 2gh. As we know that a1 is very very greater than a2, therefore equation 3 can be reduced to v2 square is equal to 2gh. Therefore, v2 is equal to under root 2gh. This is the equation of the speed of the liquid flowing out through an orifice at the depth h below the free surface. It is the same as that of the particle falling freely through a high h under a gravity. Now the next application is Venturi tube. Venturi tube is used to measure speed of flow of the fluid in a tube. As a fluid passes through the constriction, its speed increases in accordance with the equation of continuity. But the pressure decreases as by the Bernoulli equation. The fluid of density rho flows through a Venturi tube. The area of cross section A1 at the wider part and A2 at the constriction. That is, here is wider part, area of cross section is A1, and here is narrow part, that is constriction. Okay, here is area of cross section is A2. Let V1 and V2 be the speed of the fluid and P1 and P2 be the pressure at A1 and A2 respectively. Therefore, by using Bernoulli's equation, we can write here P1 plus 1 by 2 rho V1 square is equal to P2 plus 1 by 2 rho V2 square. Therefore, we can write here P1 minus P2 is equal to 1 by 2 rho V2 square minus 1 by 2 rho V1 square. Let two vertical tubes connected to a Venturi tube at A1 and A2. Then, the height difference of the liquid level in a tube is h. Therefore, we can write here P1 minus P2 is equal to rho g h. Substituting equation 2 in equation 1, we can write here rho g h is equal to 1 by 2 rho v2 square minus 1 by 2 rho v1 square. Therefore, taking the 1 by 2 rho as a common, we can write here rho g h is equal to 1 by 2 rho v2 square minus v1 square. Cancelling the rho on the both side and multiplying both side by 2, we can write here 2 g h is equal to v2 square minus v1 square. Using this equation, the rate of the flow of the liquid passing through a cross section can be calculated by knowing areas A1 and A2. The third application is lifting up of an aeroplane. When aeroplane runs on a runway, due to the aerodynamic shape of its wings, streamlines of air are crowded above the wings compared to those below the wings. these are the streamlines which are crowded above the wings, and these are the streamlines below the wings. Thus, air above the wings moves faster than that of the below. According to the Bernoulli's principle, the pressure above the wings decreases and pressure below the wing increases. So, due to this pressure difference, an upward force called as a dynamic lift acts on the bottom of the wings of a plane. When this force becomes greater than the weight of the aeroplane takes off. Now the next application is working of atomizer. The action of the carburetor of an automobile engine, paint gun and spray, scent spray or the insect spray is based on Bernoulli's principle. In all these, the tube T is dipped in a liquid. The air is blown in a high speed over a tip of this tube when with help of piston P in a cylinder. That is, the air in this section is flow with very high speed. So, this high speed air creates a low pressure over the tube. This high speed creates a low pressure at that point, due to which a liquid in it, and it is then blown with a very small droplets with expelled air. That is, if the air at this tip is moving very fastly, pressure decreases and this liquid is lifts up at that point, and due to the flowing air, this liquid it is spread in the form of small droplets. Now the next application is blowing off of ropes by stormy wind. When high speed stormy wind blows over a rooftop, it causes low pressure P above the roof according to the Bernoulli's principle. However, the air below the roof, that is inside the room, is still at atmospheric pressure PO. So due to this pressure difference, roof is lifted up and is then blown off by the wind. Thank you. Thank you very much.